Nice job, Chris. This is an original poster from 1966 of me, Spider-Man, a door panel poster that you could order through the comic book. This poster was all ripped and damaged and stained. Watch it get restored on Poster School.
Hi, I'm Zachary, and welcome to Poster School. At Poster School, we talk about the restoration of old posters. Today, we have a Spider-Man poster. You could get this poster if you had the comic book. It was advertised in the back of the comic book. All you had to do is fill out a form, send in some money, and they would send you the poster in this tube. They're going to do this for all their Marvel superheroes. I think they decided to just do Spider-Man. This is a door panel sized poster. It's huge. And now my father's gonna show you how he linen backed it. Take it away, Dad!
Thank you, Zachary. This poster was printed a long time ago, in 1966. So the paper is now become very dry. It's so dry that I have to be very careful as I unroll it because it wants to rip more. The whole reason why I'm going to mount it onto acid-free paper and canvas is to make it stronger. It's got a really big rip at the bottom that goes about 4 or 5 inches up into the writing where it says, "Your friendly neighborhood Spider-Man." This rip could get longer if I'm not careful. And that's a good reason to linen back the poster, because the linen backing will fix the rip. The glue that I use is called wheat paste. It's similar to what they use to put wallpaper on the wall, except I'm using a better kind. You might notice that I'm putting the wheat paste right onto the acid-free paper, and then I'm going to glue the poster to that. And now some more detailed history about this poster. In the Marvel Comics cover date December 1965, this ad appeared, inviting readers to guess what was contained inside a mystery tube. The following month, issues dated January 1966, the mystery was revealed. The Spider-Man poster was offered for $1.99, and there were promises for more designs to follow, but they never materialized. The ad continued to appear in comics through 1967, at which point they most likely sold out. With the success of the Fantastic Four, Marvel Comics editor and head writer Stan Lee was casting about for a new superhero idea. He said the idea for Spider-Man came from a surge in teenage demand for comic books and the desire to create a character with whom teens could identify. In his autobiography, Lee cites the non-superhuman pulp magazine Crime Fighter, The Spider, as a great influence. And in a multitude of print and video interviews, Lee stated he was further inspired by seeing a spider climb up the wall, adding in his autobiography that he has told that story so often he has become unsure of whether or not it is true. Although... Now I'm taking a roller and I'm going to gently push out the excessive air pockets that are between the poster and the paper. As I do so, I notice that some dirt is coming out in the paper as well. But this is showing me that the paper is actually stretching out so that the poster will look really good after it's mounted and dry. Stan Lee didn't do the artwork. He was the writer-editor, not the artist. He undoubtedly wrote the ad copy. The artwork for this poster was done by Marie Severin, based on a design by Spider-Man co-creator Steve Ditko.
Okay. What? Look at this. It's not a big deal. I was afraid this paint, this poster almost looks like an original.
You going to find a piece of?
No. Maybe I have it. This poster I thought was, I thought this was an original painting at first.
Yeah.
So I thought I'd have a hard time marking it, but telling you it was a poster, but it's not. The inks are stable, and it's not hard. You want to roll out a few?
Hmm?
You want to roll out a few?
No.
Thank you.
No, no, no.
No, no, no. Yee.
Even though this poster only cost $1.99 when it was first printed, today, if you want to own this poster, you have to pay $2,500. That's right, that's what this poster sold for at a recent auction. The poster is from 1966, and it's probably very rare. Scarce, indeed. There probably are no other copies of it in mint condition. This one was not mint. Now I'm rolling out the edges, the last of the wheat paste that has built up around the edge of the poster. And once I've done that, I've got to take some sponges and clean the whole poster to make sure all this dirty wheat paste is gone. Why is the wheat paste dirty? Because there was dirt in the paper and the wheat paste picked up that dirt, took it out of the poster, and now I'm cleaning it all up. This way the poster will be nice and clean. I don't want to have any paste streaks on it after it dries.
Go away. We'll be right back.
Also, a small percentage of people who watch PosterFix are actually subscribed. So if you enjoy these videos and watch them frequently, make sure to subscribe. It's free and you can always change your mind. Also, my dad is trying to hit 3,000 subscribers and it would be a really nice milestone. Spider-Man, Spider-Man, don't forget.
This and that you can touch up to match this color.
But you don't have to paint out any of the other kind of stains. I don't want to paint it. Like, for example, up here,
you can leave this like it is.
A few months after Spider-Man's introduction, publisher Goodman reviewed the sales figures for that issue and was shocked to find it was one of the highest selling comics. The mid-1960s stories reflected the political tensions of the time, as early 1960s Marvel stories had often dealt with the Cold War and communism.
Spider-Man, Spider-Man, does whatever a spider can. He spins a web of any size, catches thieves just like flies. Look out, there goes a Spider-Man.
Is his throne listen but? He's got radioactive blood. Can he swing from a thread? Take a look overhead. Look out, there goes the Spider-Man. In a chill of night, at a scene of a crime, like a streak of light, he arrives just in time.
Spider-Man, Spider-Man, friendly neighborhood Spider-Man. Wealth and fame he's ignored, action is his reward. Look out, there goes the Spider-Man.
In the chill of night, at a scene of a crime, like a streak of light, he arrives just in time.
Spider-Man, Spider-Man, friendly neighborhood Spider-Man. Wealth and fame he's ignored, action is his reward. Look out, there goes the Spider-Man.
You'll find the Spider-Man whenever there's a hang up. You'll find the Spider-Man.
This original Spider-Man poster from 1966 is complete.
Spider-Man, 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 where are you going, Spider-Man?
Spider-Man, Spider-Man.
Hi, Spidey.
Backing makes your posters stronger so they last longer. Well, this brings us to the end of Poster School. Make sure to like and subscribe, and see you next time. Bye!